Hi Adam. It's good to see you here. Where are you off to on the train today?
Oh, hi Lucy. It's great to see you too. I'm on my way to work in Admiral right now.
That's good to know. I'm glad I bumped into you, because Rob Paulsen is performing live on his birthday this year, and he is inviting all the characters he voiced to perform with him, and I was just wondering if you and the Adamantiums would like to come. He would be very excited and happy to see you all.
Oh, me and the Adamantiums would love to come and see it. Oh wait, you said every character he voiced, right?
Yes, I did. Why did you ask?
You know he voiced that horrible green-faced monster in his animated series. I really like Rob Paulsen, but not when he voiced the mask. Please don't tell me he is coming too.
Oh. I forgot that he voiced him. Oh Adam, I am so sorry. Don't worry, I will talk to Rob about it and I'll see if I can convince him not to invite the mask over. I completely forgotten that he voiced the mask in his animated series and I am so incredibly sorry Adam.
It's okay Lucy. You convincing Rob not to invite him would be really appreciated.
Okay. I will see what I can do. I really hope I can convince him, because he really wants to see you and the Adamantiums there.
Oh yeah. This is gonna be a show to remember. What better way to celebrate my birthday than to perform for the Land of Vind? This is gonna be good.
Oh my goodness, it's only Rob Paulsen.
The one and only. Oh Lucy, my number one favorite fan. It's so good to see you again. Are you excited for my show?
You bet I am, Rob. I wouldn't want to miss anything to do with you for the world. This show is gonna be the best ever, although, there is one thing I want to ask you. You know you plan to invite all the characters you voiced in your time, right?
Yes. I do plan to invite all the characters I voiced. Why did you ask?
Well, I have a friend who is absolutely terrified of the mask, and although he really likes you, he is traumatized by the mask when you voiced him in the cartoon series, and even added him into a group of criminals and makes a grounded series out of him. Can you please not invite the mask to your show tonight? I invited my friend to see you and I really don't want him to get upset. Please Rob, please don't invite the mask.
Oh really? Oh man. That's very sad. I'm so sorry that my portrayal of the mask had scared and upset your friend. I feel awful to doing so. Don't worry. I won't invite him. You can tell your friend that the mask will not be coming to my show and he doesn't have to worry.
Oh thank you Rob. Thank you so much. That really puts me at ease that he won't be coming. Now I can tell him and reassure him. Thank you Rob. You're the best.
Hey, anything for my number one fan. I cannot wait to meet your friend tonight.
Well, I am off to Rob Paulsen's show. Please make sure the mask behaves himself. I am so glad he is not coming with me.
Don't worry, Stanley. Me and Marlo will make sure he behaves himself. You go and have a good time, and we hope it all goes well for you. Marlo, will you be a good boy and feed this to the mask, please? That's a good boy. Then you can have some belly rubs from me afterwards.
Oh, come on. How is it even possible for a dog to bring me lumpy potatoes? Oh come on, lumpy potatoes tastes yuck. I want a proper meal. Besides, it's Rob Paulsen's show tonight. I should be going because he voiced me in my cartoon series. If that scruffy flea bitten mongrel mutt thinks he can stop me from going to Rob's show, he can go and fuck a lamp post. If Stanley, Tina or Milo won't let me go, then I'll go myself. I don't say somebody's not me, for nothing you know. So long, suckers. Ha 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 ha.
What is it, Marlo? What's the problem? Oh, bother him and his cartoon powers. Well, Marlo, let's go before he causes any trouble, and hurry.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome for the host for tonight, Rob Paulson.
Hello and good evening, and welcome to my show. In case you don't know me, I'm Rod Paulson, and I am a well-known voice actor for many cartoon characters, and they are all with me tonight, and we're very excited to perform for you all. Oh look, I think one of my characters is coming. Oh look, it's none other than Pinky, from Pinky and the Brain. Say hello to the audience, Pinky. What's wrong, Pinky? Have you lost your voice? Let me see if I can get it back for you. Let me try this.
Are you going to finish that croissant?
Nope. That didn't work. Let me try this one.
Oh, okay. What about this one?
Looks like that one didn't work either. Let me try one more time.
Okay then, let me try this voice. Hello, nurse!
Looks like that didn't work. Don't worry, Pinky. Let me ask an audience member. Maybe they can help. Let me see, who can I ask? Oh look who's in the audience, oh my goodness, it's only Brainiac Adam.
The one and only.
Oh Adam, it's good to see you and your friends tonight. I was hoping you would join us tonight. Thank you so much for coming. My loyal fan Lucy told me all about you. Now then, can you say to Pinky, are you pondering what I'm pondering? Think you can do that?
Of course. Hello, Pinky. Are you pondering what I'm pondering?
I think so, Adam. But if they called them sad meals, kids wouldn't buy them.
It worked. Pinky got his voice back. Thank you, Adam. Let's give Bing's biggest hero a cheer for getting Pinky's voice back. Okay, everyone, who wants a rendition of Yekko's World?
Yeah!
Okay then get ready.
United States, Canada, Mexico, Panama, Haiti, Jamaica, Peru, Republic, Dominican, Cuba, Caribbean, Greenland, El Salvador too, Puerto Rico, Colombia, Venezuela, Honduras, Guyana, and still, Guatemala, Bolivia, then Argentina, and Ecuador, Chile, Brazil, Costa Rica, Belize, Nicaragua, Bermuda, Bahamas, Tobago, San Juan, Paraguay, Uruguay, Suriname, and French Guiana, Barbados, and Guam.
Come on, everyone. Join me.
Norway and Sweden and Iceland and Finland and Germany now one piece. Switzerland, Austria, Czechoslovakia, Italy, Turkey and Greece. Poland, Romania, Scotland, Albania, Ireland, Russia, Oman. Bulgaria, Saudi Arabia, Hungary, Cyprus, Iraq and Iran. There's Syria, Lebanon, Israel, Jordan, both Yemen, Kuwait and Bahrain. The Netherlands, Luxembourg, Belgium and Portugal, France, England, Denmark and Spain. India, Pakistan, Burma, Afghanistan, Thailand, Nepal, and Bhutan, Cambodia, Malaysia, then Bangladesh, Asia, and China, Korea, Japan, Mongolia, Laos, and Tibet, Indonesia, the Philippine Islands, Taiwan, Sri Lanka, New Guinea, Sumatra, New Zealand, and Borneo, and Vietnam, Tunisia, Morocco, Uganda, Angola, Zimbabwe, Djibouti, Botswana, Mozambique, Zambia, Swaziland, Gambia, Guinea, Algeria, Ghana. Rwanda, Lesotho, and Malawi, Togo, the Spanish Sahara is gone. Niger, Nigeria, Chad, and Liberia, Egypt, Benin, and Gabon, Tanzania, Somalia, Kenya, and Mali, Sierra Leone, and Algeria, Dahomey, Namibia, Senegal, Libya, Cameroon, Congo, Zaire, Ethiopia, Guinea-Bissau, Madagascar, Rwanda, Mayor, and Cayman, Hong Kong, Abu Dhabi, Qatar, Yugoslavia, Crete, Mauritania, then Transylvania, Monaco, Liechtenstein, Malta, and Palestine.
Quickly, call the ambulance, and hurry. Adam looks like he's having a heart attack.
I'm calling 999 for the ambulance right away.
Stanley, Tina, Milo, are you guys angry at me?
Oh, congratulations, Mask. You just won understatement of the year. We are beyond angry. We are so furious and pissed off with you. We can't believe you gate crashed to Rob Paulson's show to jumpscare everyone. Are you proud and happy of what you did? I truly hope you are, because you scared and traumatized a lot of people who were in the audience, and many people are now in the hospital because of what you did.
But guys, I only did it because Rob didn't invite me to his show, and I wanted to get back at him for not inviting me.
Do you know why Rob didn't invite you? It's because you kept bullying and scaring Adam and many other people. Adam also happened to be in the audience, and he suffered a heart attack because of you. Oh yes, you are definitely standing.
But eyes.
Tonight on BBC News, a live show hosted by voice actor Rob Paulson was cancelled suddenly when one of the Alanastiums, which is the mask, had ran onto the stage and jump-scared everyone. We go live with Sandra Smith with more information about this incident.
I am live outside the Vian City Stadium. The incident took place inside the stadium, when Rob Paulson, his characters and the other cast members of the Animaniacs were performing the song known as Yakko's World, until the mask popped out of the curtains and jumpscared everyone. Luckily, most people were okay. However, some people had got hospitalized. I will be interviewing the many people who had witnessed the incident. First to be interviewed is Rob Paulson, the host of the show. Now Rob, can you please tell the viewers what had happened?
I was performing my live show, and everything was going well, but when I nearly got up to Yakko's World, the mask appeared out of nowhere and he jump-scared everyone. I feel so horrible because I promised a special person that he wouldn't appear tonight. I will see to it that he and everyone gets compensated for the incident. And Mask, if you're watching this, and you better be, I regret that I ever voiced you in your cartoon series. I had fun voicing you at first, but after how you traumatize people, including that special guest especially, I now wish I never voiced you. You are going to pay for all the damage you caused for my ruined night, and boy, you are paying a lot, and I mean, a serious lot. Thank you so much for ruining my perfect night, you ugly green-faced monster. I hope you're feeling proud of yourself. I'm disowning credit for you in future.
Thank you, Rob. Next to be interviewed is Luke Toos, a member of the Adamantiums and a worker in the insurance firm, Admiral. Now please share your story to the viewers.
Whoever you are, Mask, I hope you're fucking happy, because you scared and traumatized Adam so badly you gave him a heart attack, and now he is in the hospital. If he dies or gets the same illness as Ricky Derundick's daughter got when Dora made a fake lockdown and I'll laugh when you are your stinking Alanastiums said puddle to him, I will see to it you have serious hell to pay. You will also be paying for Adam's £900,000 hospital bill. I was enjoying a belated birthday treat until you ruined it for us. I need to go. I'm too pissed off to say anything else.
Thank you, Luke. Next up is Officer Peter Collingsworth of the Vian City Police Department. Now, Peter, is there something you want to say?
I just wanted to tell the Mask, if he is watching it, and he had better be, that we will be issuing him a £50,000 fine for the damages he caused and the other hospital bills he is issued with, and I wanted to let him know that he has only 3 days to pay for it all. Failure to do so will result in being arrested, so he better have the money by then.
And finally, we have Lucy Ritchie, also known as Lucy the CBC Kids fan, who is a fan of Rob Paulson and had attended the performance. Now Lucy, would you like to share your story please?
Well, I was watching Rob's show and I was having a great time. Near the end of the show, he was singing Yakko's World with his characters and fellow voice actors dancing with him, but when he reached the end, the mask appeared out of nowhere and jump-scared everyone. I feel so terrible because I promised a really great friend he would not turn up. I know it wasn't our fault, but I still can't help but feel we let him down.
And would you ever allow this type of behavior in your universe?
Absolutely not. I swear if any villainous character I use for my Grounded videos ever does anything like that, then they are going to be in for world of hurt. I'm going to get you for this, Mask.
Whoa. Lucy, calm down. Please calm down. We can talk about this. Lucy, Lucy.
We seem to have encountered some technical difficulties. We apologize for the inconvenience we have caused you. We will get back to you as soon as possible, and Mask, you will be paying for the damages to the camera.
Oh, yo. Boy Mask, you really done it this time. You are in so much deep trouble.
Now look at you. You had been swamped with fines and bills that you will have to pay. If you think we are going to help you out in this, you can go and fuck a lamppost.
I just can't believe this had to happen. I can't believe the mask popped out of nowhere to scare us like this. I really hope Adam will be okay.
It would be just devastating and heartbreaking if Adam dies, but it would be even worse if he wakes up to receive the same illness that Ricky Durandith's daughter and Olaf has received. Please don't let it be any of this news.
So Doctor, how is Adam? Is he going to be okay?
He is fine. We performed CPR on him which managed to return his regular heartbeat, so he will be alright. We also ran some mental tests on him too, and they are all looking good, so Adam won't wake up to any mental illnesses.
Well, we are very relieved that Adam is going to be okay. I just hope he wakes up soon.
Huh? Where am I? All I remember is that horrible green-faced nightmare had just popped out of nowhere and terrified the shit out of me. Oh man, please tell me he's not there.
Oh Adam. Oh thank God you're okay. We were all worried sick about you. We're so glad you're all right.
I am so sorry Adam. I promised you a mask-free night and I feel like I failed you. Can you ever forgive us for letting you down?
I think I'm the one who should be owing Adam an apology Lucy. I feel absolutely horrible that the mask just had to come along and ruin my special night and do this to Adam. Adam, I'm so sorry that the mask appeared and scared you. I will 100% promise you that I am going to compensate you the best way I can. I really want to make it up to you and the Adamantians after tonight.
It's okay, Lucy and Rob. I forgive you both. It wasn't your fault. None of us saw it coming.
That is very kind of you to say that, but I still feel I need to make it up to you. You'd served and protected our land and you truly deserve better than that.
I think I know what might cheer you up. Hey Morris, do you remember that one episode when the brain sang I'm a little teapot? Can you maybe sing it for us? Just to cheer Adam up?
Of course Lucy. I would be happy to.
I'm a little teapot, short and stout. This is my handle, this is my spout. When I get all steamed up, hear me shout. Tip me over and pour me out.
Oh man, that never gets old.